At one time, there was once upwards of 60 million bison in North America until commercial hunting reduced the population to only about 300 animals.
In this week's Montana Made, MTN's Jack Ginsburg shows us how one Montana rancher is making a business out of trying to return bison to the Montana landscape.
Every time we travel across the country, we'd stop to go see the buffalo and in South Dakota, North Dakota, Montana. And so it was kind of an annual trip. And I always just was fascinated with the animal. So I always knew later on in life, at some point I was gonna, you know, basically work into raising bison. And so that's where the journey started.
Jonathan did just that. He spent 9 years in the Air Force, saving up money before moving to Montana and buying his own ranch to raise and sell bison. He began selling raw and frozen pieces of bison meat until he found it wasn't going to work financially.
The cost of freezing and transportation and all this was far too high for the amount that you could raise on land and still turn a profit. I was working two jobs and I started a construction company as well, just to basically be paying this place down.
Then John met Brittany Masters in Seattle.
Yeah, I met him. He's like, I have a bison ranch. I'm like, is it grass-fed? Are you holistically managed? Are you, like, all these things?
And together, Brittany and John found a better way to sell their product.
9 months ago, we started on a journey to, shift our business model a little bit and distribute wider to more people in a cheaper format of non-frozen meat, which requires us to smoke it and dry it, which is how people have been doing it for thousands of years.
Not only did they find a cheaper way to distribute, but keeping in mind their main goal of creating a healthy product.
We thought if we're going to put out this, you know, a product, something from the ranch, we want to be able to meet those expectations because that's how we eat. You know, personally, we eat very healthy.
The bison jerky they make is sugar-free, but John says that doesn't take away from the taste.
People think, well, if you eat healthy, it's going to taste bad, and that's just it's not the case either with this product. You know, we really like eating savory products, and so what we put out, you know, although we only use bison and organic spices, we utilize the natural sweetness of bison meat to still give it that tang that people really like in getting a sweet jerky product, but it's not overdone.
The more I talked to John and Brittany, the more I realized they weren't just in the business to make money, but more so to spread awareness of healthy eating and the benefits of raising healthy bison.
Two-thirds of what we do is promotion and education, and maybe a third of what we do is selling. So, you know, that's kind of, we wrap it all into one: education, raising, and, you know, a healthy product out there.
Not only does raising healthy bison benefit the humans who eat it, but the land the bison roam as well.
The thing we're passionate about, not just creating healthy food, but creating healthy land out here. And bison are, you know, the animal that created basically North America.
Grasslands are the most endangered ecosystem in all of North America, and these bison you see here behind me are helping to repair that. As bison graze, their hooves break the soil, bury seeds, and create millions of small pockets in the earth to capture precious moisture and topsoil.
Through John and Brittany's business, they are hoping that they will inspire others to raise bison and bring the population back to even a fraction of what it once was. They know that Montana is a special place, and their business is possible because of where they live.
We wouldn't be able to do this anywhere else but Montana.
Mm-hmm.
You know, yeah. Truthfully, you know, not, you know, the cost of the land, the land that you need to raise bison. I mean, there's not too many, you know, properties out there that you can actually still own in any other state or any other country for that matter.
By the way, Jack tells us roam-free owners travel the state in that transformed trailer you saw there, teaching people about the company and the benefits of raising bison. Find out more about their company by visiting our websites.
I like the idea of the mission, though, saying, you know, we can change this, we can do something about
absolutely.
It.
Absolutely.
Pretty cool stuff.
I love seeing a bison, too. That's always
yeah,
good.
And some jerky.
Always.